As of February 17th of 2025, there are currently 47 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is one less than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, which has largely gone under the radar of those not immediately living nearby, is the Kanlaon volcano in the Philippines. Located in the center of the island of Negros, this volcano has been near continuously erupting primarily through weak but persistent ash emissions that rise no more than 1,000 meters above its towering summit crater. However, on occasion, larger ash emissions have occurred, including two powerful explosions that released pyroclastic flows on June 3rd and December 9th of 2024. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Indonesia, due to the potential fear that a major eruption could occur at the Lewotobi volcano, its alert level was raised to its highest level, red. Meanwhile, in the Philippines, the Taal volcano erupted three times this week via small explosive eruptions in its summit crater lake. And, in what is this week's top story, Italy's famed Mount Etna volcano has put on a spectacular show via both strong explosive and diffusive activity in what marks its first true paroxysm of 2025. After essentially being quiet for the first month of 2025, Mount Etna's southeast crater came to life on February 6, producing a series of weak Volcanoes explosions. These explosions grew progressively stronger over time, and soon, more small vents opened up due to an underlying fissure to the west of the southeast crater. These vents ejected black and brown ash and threw bombs of lava as much as 250 meters into the air. As the frequency of these explosions continued to increase, the fissure grew to and then stopped about 800 meters west-southwest of the southeast crater. On February 8th, the western end of said fissure began effusing lava, which despite what many reports say isn't technically basaltic. Instead, as you might have guessed from its slightly more viscous appearance when compared to, say, Kilauea basalt lava flows, this lava has a presumably more silica and alkali-rich composition of basaltic trachy andesite. This lava flow slowly crept down Mount Etna's snow-covered western flanks at a speed which averaged slower than a garden snail, 0.0269 miles per hour or 43.3 meters an hour. However, due to an initially higher effusion rate, this lava flow traveled a full mile during its first day, and by the end of its second day, it reached 2.25 kilometers downslope, now marking it as the longest lava flow since 2019. As explosive summit activity continued at multiple vents, this lava flow crept far enough downslope to actually hit a patch of forest and burn it before covering a local road. This lava flow in only 8 days has flowed a total of 2.5 miles downslope, reaching a lower elevation of 1,850 meters. The explosive activity even led to some air traffic cancellations at the local Catania airport on February 16th. It is unknown how much longer Etna's paroxysm will last for, but I recommend at least viewing some additional fantastic footage posted by various people this week. Meanwhile, in Indonesia, the still-erupting laki-laki cone of the Lewotobi volcano seemingly constricted during much of the last month, creating the potential for a plug to form and thus a powerful explosive event to occur. Then, on February 12th, it appeared that a plug formed as visible eruptive activity ceased and the rate of earthquakes and tremor jumped by 600%. Being rightfully concerned that a possible repeat of Lewotobi's two powerful explosions last year, which threw lava bombs that landed up to 11 kilometers away and incinerated more than 20 square kilometers of forest via pyroclastic flows, the alert level of the laki-laki cone was raised from orange to red. This occurred alongside a mandatory exclusion zone of 6 kilometers in all directions, expanding to 7 kilometers in 180 degree arc from northeast to southwest. Well, seismic activity seemingly escalated and then nothing happened. It turns out that during this time, a magma sill intrusion drained some of the laki-laki cone's magma as it intruded near, but did not reach the southern Perempuan cone. So, a possible third disaster was thankfully averted for now, and Laki-Laki produced its first explosion in 5 days on February 17th. Heading to the Philippines, the Taal volcano produced three minor explosive phreatic eruptions as heated acidic water in its crater lake flashed to steam and exploded. These explosions occurred with one each on February 13th, February 16th, and February 17th, with each eruption lasting a mere 3 to 4 minutes. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on February 17th of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, E10, for supporting my work.